Packers. The day before the Jets played Oakland in the championship game, the winner was going to go to the Super Bowl against the Baltimore Colts. And at about 4 o'clock in the morning, my friend Pepe saw Namath walking down the street with a blonde on one arm and a bottle in the other arm. And my friend Pepe, who was a professional gambler, immediately rushed to the telephones to wake up every bookmaker he knew to get down all the money he had to his name on Oakland. And of course, he lost.
Welcome to 5-8 Football on Classic Sports Network. Even during the most heated rivalries, fans have been known to leave the stadium early if their team is getting blown out. This is especially true on the congested freeways of Los Angeles. When 5th-ranked Notre Dame traveled to Los Angeles to meet USC on November 30, 1974, no one expected a blowout. The Irish had the top-ranked defense in the country. The Trojans headed into the game at 8-1-1, behind offensive star Anthony Davis and quarterback Pat Hayden. We take you now to the Los Angeles Coliseum for Notre Dame against USC, November 30th, 1974.
Notre Dame, bound for the Orange Bowl, having won 9 of 10 games this year, ranked 5th nationally. Southern California, with a record of 8-1-1, ranked 4th in the UPI, 6th in the AP poll, and headed for the Rose Bowl against Ohio State. Notre Dame leads in this series over the years, 26 wins, 15 losses, 4 ties. But over the last 7 years, USC has taken the edge, 4 wins, 1 loss, and 2 ties. The crowd today will be upwards of 90,000. It is 69 degrees. A perfect day for football, and the Fighting Irish are coming onto the floor of the Los Angeles Coliseum. Notre Dame, coached by Ara Persigian. Wearing the white uniforms, the road jerseys today. Notre Dame has come into this football stadium many times against these University of Southern California Trojans, and here comes USC out of the tunnel. Traveler 2 with Dick Sacco. Moving around the track here in the Coliseum as the Southern California band strikes up. And good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Keith Jackson. I'll be calling the play for you today. Working with us is our guest analyst and commentator, a man who has the longest-running television show, I think, in the country, Woody Hayes, the head football coach at Ohio State University. You've had a television program going for some 24 years, Coach.
24 years, that's right.
Coach, you have a chance today to see firsthand the football team that your Buckeyes take on New Year's Day in the Rose Bowl.
Yes, I'm particularly interested in them, and I'm particularly interested in how Era goes about attacking them, too.
Notre Dame now has used defense. They lead the country in total defense this year. They have used that defense, I think, as a weapon in achieving field position.
They certainly have, but I wouldn't pick them any superior to that team we played last week in defense, Michigan. They're a great defensive team, too, as you saw. But it is a great weapon, and they get to see all your films nowadays, so it's pretty hard to fool anybody with your offense. And they are a great defensive team, and they do something else I sort of like. They run that fullback a lot, and that's pretty good football.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing the players. The defensive team for the Notre Dame Fighting Irish, number 70, from Cincinnati, Ohio, left end Steve Niehaus. Number 60 from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, left tackle Kevin Nosbusch. Number 88 from Tulsa, Oklahoma, right tackle Mike Fanning. Number 48 from Barberton, Ohio, right end Jim Stock. Number 50 from Troy, Michigan, linebacker Greg Collins. Number 45 from Farmington, Michigan, linebacker Drew Mahalik. Number 42 from Elkhart, Indiana, linebacker Tom Eastman. Number 14 from Flint, Michigan, defensive halfback Reggie Barnett. Number 16 from Palmer Park, Maryland, defensive halfback Randy Payne. Number 41 from Hobart, Indiana, safety John Dubinetsky. Number 10 from Hammond, Indiana, free safety Randy Harrison. And the head coach of the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame, Errol Posegun. And now introducing seniors from the University of Southern California. Number 92 from St. Joseph's, Louisiana, nose guard Otha Bradley. Number 73, Granada Hills, California, defensive tackle Greg Mardarian. Number 49 from Pasadena, California, rover Charles Phillips. Number 37 from San Pedro, California, linebacker Ken Gray. Number 11 from Covina, California, place kicker Chris Limahelu. Number 56 from Montebello, California, offensive guard Mike Smith. Number 16 from San Pedro, California, flanker John Cadwell. Number 25 from Covina, California, split in John McKay. Number 9 from Danuba, California, quarterback Rob Adolph. Number 21 from San Dimas, California, tailback Alan Carter. Number 10 from West Covina, California, starting quarterback Pat Hayden. Number 28 from San Fernando, California, starting tailback Anthony Davis. And the head coach of the Southern California Trojans, John McKay. USC and Notre Dame in a moment.
We'll be right back with more of Notre Dame versus USC on Phi Beta Football. This classic sports presentation is brought to you by Coca-Cola Classic. Always the real thing, always Coca-Cola.
Announcing the arrival of the Coca-Cola ATM MasterCard. Redeemable at any consenting MasterCard ATM. I'm just a love machine.
You know, I was into all that extreme stuff when I was your age. Just didn't have a fancy name for it. Because I never had a Subaru Outback Sport either.
Too bad, Uncle. This beauty's got a ton of cargo space. Full-time all-wheel drive. More horsepower than a RAV4. We never did that, I'll bet.
Sure we did. But, what's the rape for?
Outback Sport, part of the Outback family from Subaru.
Happen to you? Drink Keystone Light, America's never bitter beer, so there's always a great taste, never a bitter face.
Have you ever ridden a hog?
No, but I've ridden a pony.
Stop making faces. Drink Keystone.
When you ship with Priority Mail, it's a great way to save money. But what about other parts of the world? There's Global Priority Mail. And here's the best part. Give us a few days more, and you can save up to 70% over FedEx or UPS. So, what's your global priority? Try Global Priority Mail from the U.S. Postal Service.
Classic Sports delivers the fight cards you don't want to miss. A ringside seat to the world's largest library of boxing's best fights. From lightweights to heavyweights, you don't have to wait, because every night is fight night. Tonight at the Fights, weeknights on Classic Sports.
We now return to Notre Dame versus USC on Phi Beta Football.
Chris Limahalu will kick off for the University of Southern California. And the ball game is underway. The Fighting Irish and the Trojans for the 46th time. The kick is very short. Fielded short by Tim Weiler of Notre Dame. And he brings it back a very short distance as SC's kick coverage is very good. And the Trojans stop the Irish at about the 20-yard line. There, Notre Dame will go to work, and along the front, the Irish line up like this. 91 is Weber. He's the tight end. Remember him from the Sugar Bowl a year ago. 64 is Nice. 66, Wujak. Winneman in the middle. DiNardo, Sylvester, Demily wide. Clements, the quarterback. Mark McClain listed, but it's Eric Pinnick coming out of the backfield and starting. Wayne Bullock is the fullback, and the wingback is Samuel. And it's the fullback, Bullock, going to the right side of the line, moving behind the right tackle, and he gets a yard, maybe two, and that's all. So as Notre Dame picks up short yardage of 2 yards in his first carry, let's set the Notre Dame, or rather the Southern California defense. 79 is Gary Jeter. Otha Bradley is 92. Art Riley is number 70. Number 87 is Ed Powell. He is actually listed as a linebacker. The other linebackers are Kevin Bruce, 50, Richard Wood, 83, and Dale Mitchell, 85. And Notre Dame on the second offensive play of the ball game. Notre Dame finding Southern California stacking and hitting hard as the ball is advanced. Very shortly, I'll give him 2 more yards. Call it a 2-yard pickup and bring up third down and a long six. In the deep secondary for Southern California, it's Danny Reese, 46, Marvin Cobb, 24, Charles Phillips, 49, and Ron Bush, number 23. It is a very quick, defendable secondary, one that may bend a little but seldom breaks. At least it has not broken very much this year. Tom Clements will go to the air on third down and a long six. He pops the ball in there. The pass is complete. Good for a first down to Al Samuel, number 24. And so Notre Dame goes to the air on third and long and gets the first down. Our guest analyst and commentator today is Coach Woody Hayes of Ohio State.
Yes, and that was certainly a great call. They came underneath the Southern Cal defense with their halfback, and it was just as good a call as they could possibly make. It sure worked, because they were in trouble on that drive.
Samuel twisting a leg or an ankle. As you look at Notre Dame's record, he comes out. Terry Urich, number 40, goes in at the wingback position, and it's Urich in motion now. The handoff is given away to the fullback, Wayne Bullock. And he goes from the 33-yard line on the first down play across the 35 to about the 37. He was cut down by Otha Bradley, the nose guard, number 92 for Southern California. Notre Dame is wearing the white Southern California in the home crimson, or scarlet, if you like. Bradley is a senior out of St. Joseph's, Louisiana, and he's a good one. And he lines up right on the nose of Mark Brenneman, the center for Notre Dame. You look at Tom Clements, another of the Heisman Trophy candidates. And Clements gives the ball to his fullback Bullock, who is the leading ground gainer for the Fighting Irish, and he's got a couple of yards, that's all, as Southern California linebackers pinch in and nail him at the 39-yard line.
And now they've got to come up with another relatively long situation. That's one of the toughest calls in football right there. Third and three. Do you pass or do you run? It's usually a little too far to run for the first down, and you have to go to the air. Let's see what they do.
Well, you like the fullback play in these kind of plays. I know,
yeah.
Coach, yourself.
Well, it's a little far, though, for that fullback now. Yeah,
right,
there it is. He didn't make it. That's a counter play.
Art Riley, number 70, nails Clements back at the 35-yard line.
And I don't think that was a pass at all. I think that was definitely the counter play that Arrow's been using since he was at Northwestern. He didn't quite get it, and this is a particularly important place in the game, because Southern Cal on this one can get pretty good field position.
Charles Phillips, number 49, is the deep man. Tony Brantley will do the punting for Notre Dame.
It's only 43 yards deep. He's about right.
Brantley's kick is away.
The ball
a low kick.
Is low.
A little bit short. Fair catch is called, however.
Good call by that back. That's a good. They're on 35-yard line.
31-yard punt on the play, and the ball is down at the 35-yard line, just inside the 35 for the University of Southern California Trojans. And the Trojans offensively will line up like this. Jim Obradovich will be the tight end, number 89. Powell, number 76. Davis, 64. McCaffrey in the middle. Bain on the right side at guards. Knutson, the tackle, and John McKay is the split end. The quarterback is Pat Hayden. The eye back or the deep man is Anthony Davis, and he's got it on the student body left. Here he comes, running around the left side. He moves it from just inside the 35 out to about the 38-yard line. He picked up the better part of 4 yards on the carry.
All right, Niehaus, the great end or tackle, they call him, for Notre Dame. Watch him number 70 come out here now. good speed. He's a big man, about 260, and he made the tackle for a 3-yard gain.
Randy Payne, number 16, young junior from Palmer Park, Maryland, stuck his head in there and got a piece of the action. It's second down and 7 yards to go for Southern California. Let's see if they go to Davis the other way, to the wide side.
That's exactly right. The other side.
Anthony Davis has no room, and Barnett, number 14, runs him down, and there is a loss on the play.
They come up third and 10 now, and this is a big call, too.
The Southern California starting backfield. Davis is 28. 15 is the fullback for the Southern California Trojans, Dave Farmer. Number 26 is the white man, Shelton Diggs. And number 10 is Pat Hayden, the quarterback. Kevin Nosbusch, who was injured in practice on Wednesday, is in the lineup. We don't know how long he'll play, but he's in there right now. As Notre Dame sets up a five-man front, and Hayden on third down and 10 will put it up. He wants to go deep. He delivers short to Obradovich, and Obradovich is nailed at the 40-yard line, short of the first down, and Notre Dame holds the ball, and was it picked off? Drew Mihalik came out of there with a football. Drew Mihalik, number 45 for Notre Dame. As Hayden was back, the deep men were covered very well by the Notre Dame secondary, and that's that man-to-man coverage that Notre Dame sometimes goes to, and the ball was thrown into Obradovich, the short man, couldn't handle it, and Drew Mihalik comes out of there with it.
It's a real big break early in the ball game. Ball first and 10 on the 39.
Turnovers, turnovers, turnovers. They really haunt you. Here comes Clements now. We mentioned earlier that Notre Dame has used defense as a primary weapon for field position. They've got it now. Clements wants to catch it in. Going deep. He's got a man wide open. It is Goodman. And Goodman is out of bounds inside the 20-yard line. First down, Notre Dame at the Southern California 18-yard line. A gain of 21 on the play.
Right now, up to this point, it would look like neither team can run much, but they certainly can pass. The pass has been the big play up to now.
All right, Goodman comes off the field, and Samuel goes in at what amounts to the wingback position, the way Notre Dame moves the football. Eric Pinnick, number 44, is in the halfback position alongside of Wayne Bullock as a setback. Clements, he gives the football to Bullock, big hole up the middle. Bullock is inside the 10. He goes to about the 9-yard line before he is brought down. He got a great block from Al Wujek, number 66, and Mark Brenneman, the center, number 59.
That's truly a diversified offense. They run their fullbacks, their halfbacks, they passed off fullback action. They're giving Southern Cal plenty of problems right now. Now they've got a second and one on the 9.
Bullock has carried the ball twice. He's gained 10 yards. So far in the ball game, he sets up with Pinnick. It's Samuel in motion. They give the ball to Bullock again. He goes inside the 5. He's got a first and goal to go at the Southern California 4-yard line.
It's an ideal setup to score when you only have 4 yards and 4 downs to make it.
First down and goal to go as Notre Dame's Drew Mihalik, linebacker, comes up with a pass interception to give Notre Dame the football. At the 39-yard line, the Irish went for 21 yards on the pass play. They gained 9 yards, they gained 5 yards, and you got it. First down and goal to go at the 4.
Notre Dame in white. Thing.
Clements turns and he gives to his big fullback. And the big fullback, Bullock, goes pounding into the middle. He's down to about the 2-yard line.
He's a lot of power. He means an awful lot to that effort.
And Anthony Davis watching from the bench, waiting for his chance. Southern California in trouble early in the ball game, as you see, 9.5 minutes to play in the first quarter in Notre Dame. Second down, goal to go from the 2-yard line.
Go back again.
Touchdown, Notre Dame. Steve Sylvester, Steve Meese, Jerry DiNardo. They're the men that blew the hole, opened the door for the touchdown of the Fighting Irish. Get on the board. Let's have a look at the play from the end zone. Easy walk in for Bullock.
He couldn't have had a much better hole than that.
Frank Alaco comes in the hole, and in for the extra point try is Dave Reeve. Number 3, a freshman out of Bloomington, Indiana. The kick is in the air. He splits the uprights with it. And so with 9 minutes and 20 seconds to play in the first quarter, Notre Dame exercises the opportunity presented them They go in for the touchdown and take the lead over USC 7-0.
We'll be right back with more of Notre Dame versus USC on Phi Beta Football.
You had the money.
Well, it's gone.
This is the way things work. It is the same every day. We have a schedule with many stops to make. People depend on us to arrive in time. I cannot hold up a whole boat waiting for two people to find lost cash money.
Got a backup plan? Take American Express Traveler's Checks. $300 worth could save the day.
It's famous for hushing highways and reducing wind to a whisper. It's as comfortable and quiet as you want it to be. It's steering wheel mounted audio controls that let you live your life like a movie and score your own soundtrack. It's a 210 horsepower performance, and you've got front row seats. It's the RL from Acura. The true definition of luxury. Yours.
The quarterback has got to have an arrogant quality about him, because he's going to get shot at by so many people, and if he's paranoid, then he'll never make it.
I never believed in turning the other cheek. I feel that off the field, that, you know, after you've played a game with someone and competed as hard as you could against them, you can be as nice as you want to with them, but on that field, he's your enemy.
When you work hard at something and you accomplish the goal, which is to win the biggest game and to play well to do it, it's a feeling that it still stays with me. I still remember that first Super Bowl, and it still brings back great feelings.
Being the leader, I guess, being the leader and in total charge of everything that's happening on that football field from an offensive standpoint was my responsibility, and it was fun.
This past Sunday, David Wells did what few pitchers have ever done. To celebrate one of baseball's rarest achievements, Classic Sports Network presents a tribute to the perfect game. Look back with Don Larson at his 1956 World Series gem.
27 up, 27 down.
And relive Jim Bunning's perfect day in 1964. Few pitchers have ever earned the right to be called perfect. Join Classic Sports as we salute them on Tribute to the Perfect Game. Tonight at 8, only on Classic Sports Network.
We now return to Notre Dame versus USC on Phi Beta Football.
The University of Southern California sends number 22, Dwight Ford, and number 28, Anthony Davis, deep. Anthony Davis going to the goal line. Ford is a freshman, and he can really fly. He's right back there with him. Now, when the ball is kicked by Pat McLaughlin of Notre Dame, they will come off as split backs. In other words, they'll split away from each other, and the man closest to the ball will take it. All three fullbacks. In other words, USC has six running backs as their deep men, but McLaughlin will give him very little chance to return. He just knocked it out of the ballpark. McLaughlin is a junior from Santa Barbara, California, which is a lovely community about 90-odd miles up the road from where this football game is being played. So Southern California gets the ball first down at their own 20-yard line as Notre Dame goes 39 yards, five plays, using a minute and 36 seconds for the touchdown, and Wayne Bullock carried the ball four of those five times. The other play was a 21-yard pass play from Tom Clements to Ron Goodman. All right, McCaffrey's over the ball for Southern California. Pat Hayden, number 10, sets the Trojans. And the handoff goes to Anthony Davis, and Davis is hit right at the line of scrimmage. And he took a solid wallop from Niehaus. Niehaus, number 70.
He simply rid himself of the tackle blocker and just made it. That's the kind of a hit that doesn't do a back any good either.
It not only discourages him emotionally, it might discourage him physically.
He might get a cracked rib out of something like that.
Johnny McKay on the sideline, the great box, walking up and down. Davis has carried three times. He picked up no yard. Hayden back on a throw. Look downfield, got a man over the middle. He threw it too late.
Yeah, it's just a little bit too late. He went good and deep to make sure he had good protection, and the man had gone just a little bit too far.
Shelton Diggs, number 26. One of the great leapers in college football. He can go as high as anybody I know to chase a football. We get a change now at fullback as Farmer, number 15, comes in, replacing Mosi Tatutu. Tatupu is a freshman out of Honolulu. Farmer is a junior out of Lapa-Wede. All right, it's third down and 10 yards to go. For Southern California, the ball is at the 20. Davis breaks it up the middle, gets to about the 30-yard line on a draw.
I thought there was an offside there at the middle guard.
Looked like the middle guard for Notre Dame moved early, but perhaps...
Maybe he didn't get into the across the line of scrimmage, but looks like he moved pretty early.
They're just shy of the first down. They need no more than 6 inches for it. It'll be fourth down, and Pat Hayden looks to the sidelines to John McKay. They're down 7-0 with 8 minutes and 13 seconds to play in the first quarter. It is so very close. The question is, do we gamble this early in the ball game?
Yeah, that's a big, big call.
Looks like they're going to go.
So they send in their goal line defenses. Two men going in are in there to stop that short yardage play.
The fullback is Ricky Bell, number 42 for this one. Bell is a big strong youngster, sophomore out of Los Angeles, 215 pounder. Hayden, sneak.
I don't know.
If that linesman marks it as he runs in, Notre Dame picks over the ball. Southern California gambles in the first quarter, and Notre Dame holds them. Greg Collins, number 50, the linebacker. Watch him.
Yes, he sure does.
He plugged the gap as USC tried the wedge.
Now, USC defense better dig in or they're in real trouble. Or they'll be 14 points behind the first quarter, and that's pretty rough.
Tom Clements gets the ball at the 29-yard line, and he still got it. Comes back to throw. Gets it passed off, going deep. Got a man. Touchdown! Notre Dame, Pete Beverly, 29 yards for the touchdown.
Beverly has caught more passes than the rest of Notre Dame team put together. And they got a good fake to the fullback inside. He has a running play, and he's out of there. The ball is perfectly thrown. The lead is just exactly what it should be. And he's open. There it is.
And Dave Reeve is in for the extra point. The SC gamble backfires as Notre Dame jumps to a two-touchdown lead, and Reeve's kick is in the middle. And with 7 minutes and 39 seconds to play in this 46th meeting between Southern California and Notre Dame, the Fighting Irish have jumped to a 14-0 lead.
You're watching Notre Dame versus USC on Phi Beta Football.
I don't think this is working out.
You're dumping me?
I mean, you're a really nice guy and all.
Then what is it? Would it be that?
Don't let this happen to you. Drink Keystone Light, America's never bitter beer, so there's always a great taste, never a bitter face.
I've changed my mind.
As if.
Stop making faces. Drink Keystone.
I don't even know who that is.
My crew's acting a little tense. Thought I'd loosen them up a bit. Hey, guys. Is your work guarantee? Lifetime guarantee? What do you think this is, Dale? That GM Goodrich Service Plus?
Smart guy. Select GM dealers now give you a lifetime guarantee on parts and labor, plus upfront pricing, plus courtesy transportation.
GM Goodrich Service Plus, like they say.
The plus means better!
Call for the select GM dealer near you.
The world thinks American soccer is second rate. The world thinks we don't belong here. The world thinks our team is weak. The world thinks they can intimidate me. We'll see about that.
We decided to get a PC.
We?
But we didn't want to pay for a lot of fancy extras. Gateway even told us what not to get.
When you call 1-800-GATEWAY, we'll build a Gateway computer just for you.
We built the Geissler's a PC for cruising the net with a powerful Intel Pentium 2 processor and a printer for only $14.99.
Let's email the kids our scores.
Want us to build a PC to fit your budget? Call us. Let's talk about your gateway.
Sports Network, the greatest new network in the history of sports.
Welcome back to the 1974 Notre Dame USC game. Notre Dame kicked a 20-yard field goal, giving the Fighting Irish a 17-0 lead. USC now has the ball on their 43 with 5 minutes left in the half.
Southern California now facing third down and 15. Hayden swings it out to Davis, and Davis almost hideous block behind the line of scrimmage. It's Jimmy Stock again. Jim Stock, number 48, the junior out of Farmington, Ohio. A loss of 4 yards on the play, and Southern California will have to punt it. When the pass was deflected, we'll show you that play in a moment. As Woody Hayes had commented, John McKay, intended receiver, had been open on it, but Hayden couldn't get the ball to it. We'll show it to you in a minute. Right now, Southern California's got to punt it away with Harrison and Burkmeyer going deep. And we get contact along the line of scrimmage, draws penalty flags, and they'll see what happens here. But in the meantime, Woody, as you noted, John McKay really had become a primary target for the first time in a ball game and had broken free. Here we see it on replay.
Yeah, he was open for the score because there's no center fielder on that play. And the ball just never got away. Notre Dame's put on a great, great rush. They're using their linebackers most of the time in it, and they're doing a great job of rushing. And of course, the Southern Cal quarterback is rather short. That's why John McKay sets him so deep.
All right, Lucas back in punt formation now for Southern California with Harrison and Burkmeyer. The return man, big rush for the Irish. Great kick by Lucas. Turned it over. Burkmeyer backs it all the way up, back to the 15-yard line. Retreats to the 14-yard line. Comes back to the 20, and down he goes at the 21. 49-yard punt by Lucas and a 4-yard return by Burkmeyer with 3 minutes and 42 seconds to play in the first half. Notre Dame scoring 14 points within a period of, well, actually a minute and 41 seconds of the first quarter. Exercising field position both times. Took it in for the touchdowns and got a 20-yard field goal from Dave Reeve, and they lead 17-0 as we come toward the end of the first half of play. Notre Dame with the ball, first down at their own 21-yard line. Wayne Bullock is out of the lineup. He has sprained his left ankle. Tom Parisi, number 36, is the fullback. The ball is given away to Mark McClain, number 22, and McClain is run down by Charlie Phillips. Right along the line of scrimmage, he may have lost the yard. And of course, Phillips was the man who picked off the Clements pass a few moments ago to stop the Notre Dame drive. McClain is a sophomore, 204-pounder out of Wilmington, Delaware. He did lose a yard on the play. One lone remaining back now for Notre Dame. Two wide receivers to the left side. They send Pinnick in motion, give the ball to the fullback, Parisi. He's got a yard, maybe two, as he tries to move it behind Wujek, Brenneman, and DiNardo, with Riley and Bradley making the stop for Southern California.
It looks like Notre Dame's going to be satisfied to use up as much of the clock as they can, then punt out of there and keep good field position, which is certainly good sound football when you've got a 17-point lead.
Third down and 8 yards to go. The ball is out at the 23-yard line. Again, Pinnick is the man in motion. Clements on a roll left. Wants to put it up. Gets it. Lobs it. Pass is caught all right. Right on the sidelines. And it's ruled a completed pass. Caught by McClain coming out of the backfield for a gain of 14 yards on the play. And a Notre Dame first down.
I sure call that one wrong.
Great throw by Clements. Just lobbed it, put it up in the air, and let it drift over the head of the defender. And the youngster McClain ran right underneath it. So it's first down at the 37-yard line for the Fighting Irish. 2 minutes and 19 seconds to play in the first half. Bennett, let me put it up again. He looks for Demele, throws it away. Demele was surrounded by a couple of Trojans over there. Very little chance to deliver the ball accurately, and Clements just drilled it out of bounds.
At least he stopped the clock. He's still got 2 minutes to score. 2 minutes and 13 seconds.
Pat Hayden, who's had a rough day so far. Pat has not had the kind of season that he wanted. He's been working, worked for a long time during the middle of the season with a bruised hand, sprained finger. Urich, number 40, goes in motion, takes the fake. They want to set up a screen. The screen goes to Goodman, and Goodman pops it out of there. He goes down to the Southern California 48-yard line. It's another first down for Notre Dame, a gain of 14 yards on the play, and Mark Brenneman, the center, again throws a big block.
That was well executed because you have to trap the first man coming up, and they did a good job. They got a couple men ahead of the ball and another first down, and they've still got time to score. And you can bet they're sure aware of that.
Inside 2 minutes now as they move the chains. The clock starts to move again, and we go to a minute and 50, and Parisi goes into the middle. He gets a couple of yards. Otha Bradley 92, Art Riley 70.
They've got
to stop.
Excuse me, they've got two times out left. It looks like they're going to need them both.
Clock is running as we come up to a minute and a half for the white-shirted Irish. Number 66 is Al Wujak, a junior out of Newark, New Jersey. Notre Dame has 15 first downs in this ball game already as Clements, under pressure, gets the pass away, and it is caught by Goodman, and he's inbound. It's McAfee, it is, 81. Let's take a look at it. Big number 81, he's 6'5", 235, and right on the sideline. Oh, that's close. That was close. As a Trojan supporter right there. Long day so far for her and for a lot of SC faithful as Clemens rolls out on the 26-yard line, delivers it. It is McAfee again. And he catches it at the 8-yard line. First and goal to go for Notre Dame. He's a big, strong youngster who is.
Well, they're getting that cross action in there. That's freezing the linebackers and holding them up, and Arrow's always been great on this cross action pattern.
A minute and 3 seconds to go. The ball is at the 9-yard line. First down and goal to go. McLean goes in motion.
There's the ball.
They throw it off this time to McLean, and he scores.
That was the ball play to the man in motion.
And we've seen that three or four times in the ball game where that man in motion has come along, gone through the fake with Clements. This time Clements gave him the ball for the first time, and McLean took it in for 9 yards, and Notre Dame runs it off to a big lead here in the first half with 53 seconds to play. They're going for the 24th point. Alaco to hold and Reeve to kick. He's got it. And so with 53 seconds to play in the first half here at the Coliseum, the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame have jumped off to a 24-0 lead.
Hi, I'm Lynn Dawson, and you're watching Classic Sports.
If swing is your thing, then step into the ring every Friday night as Classic Sports headlines the greatest bouts of all time. From cool cats and hard-hitting hipsters to the hottest licks and rivalries the sweet science has ever known. It's boxing's most happening championship bouts. Plus, get the inside beat with the word on the street from hard-nosed scribes who don't pull any punches. It's Sonny Liston night on Friday Night at the Fights with guest Jack Newfield. Friday at 9, only on Classic Sports.
We wouldn't recommend trying. This isn't just any car.
It's a dirty car, but somebody has to wash it. Now, clean your car so fast it's like magic with the amazing new ShamZammy, the water-powered miracle car wash system. Watch. Attach any hose to the ShamZammy handle, fill with detergent, then power spin your car to that showroom shine clean. The soft, brushless ShamZammy head is so gentle, it won't scratch your car's fine finish. Yet, the powerful rotating swivel head scrubs away dirt. The adjustable power head angles easily across the contours of your car. The secret is the gear-driven patented design that delivers a whirlwind of water power. So lightweight, it power floats the dirt away effortlessly. Switch from wash mode to spray mode for perfect rinsing action. Add car wax for that showroom shine. But that's not all. ShamZammy comes with a rotating power brush head to tackle tires, hubcaps, tar and grease, blast away bumper sludge, and insects ground into your grill. No job is too big or too small with ShamZammy. Power wash your deck. Power clean outdoor furniture quickly and easily. The amazing ShamZammy comes with not one but two extensions for a full 5-foot reach. Power clean your siding so it's spotless. ShamZammy even power washes your windows. Lightweight yet sturdy, you'll power clean the roof of your van or truck. With water-saving valve, you control the flow. Fantastic for hanging plants. It's perfect for boats. Cleans windshields, fiberglass, teak, and chrome. Swivel head and extension arms reach the toughest spots. Now you can own the amazing power pack ShamZammy for only $19.95. You get the powerful brushless swivel head, the rotating power brush, and two extensions for a full 5-foot reach. Order your ShamZammy today.
To order your ShamZammy, have your credit card ready and call toll-free 1-800-819-7600. Or send check or money order for $19.95 plus $5.95 shipping and handling to ShamZammy, 809 Stewart Lane, Brentwood, Tennessee. But for quicker service, call 1-800-819-7600.
Watch classic sports. It's the greatest of all time.
My cable company just picked it up. You'll come over.
Cool.
And this time, bring chips.
I'm calling my cable company. I gotta get classic sports, and you can't stop me.
Classic sports. Classic sports.
Yes, we just got classic sports. We got it.
Hey, all these guys get it.
So don't leave your friends out in the cold. Spread the word about Classic Sports Network today.
We now return to Notre Dame versus USC on Phi Beta Football.
So a freshman McAfee makes two big plays in that drive by Notre Dame, and a sophomore McLean takes it in from 9 yards, but he got great blocking on the right side from Sylvester and Donardo that opened the door for him. And I never want to ever forget Coach Hayes to give the guys at the trenches the credit.
That's right. That's right. That hole is just as big as anyone would be.
Here's the touchdown again.
He's in motion and stops. Gets the ball. Look at the hole. Look at the fullback's block.
And Parisi took a really the only defender SC had in posture to make the tackle. He just cut him down.
That's right.
All right, Davis is deep along with Ford. McLaughlin kicks off. This time he squibs it, and it's going to go out of bounds. So that'll cost them 5, and they'll do it again with 53 seconds to play in the first half.
That's real good football to do that, because there's no use giving a man like Anthony Davis a chance to bring him back or whoever else is in there. And even though you take a 5-yard penalty, it's still worth doing. It's good football. I wonder sometimes if it helps the game, but it certainly is good for the team that does it.
They'll bring it back to the 35-yard line.
Southern Cal would be smart if they moved up a little bit on this, because they're not going to kick it deep. You can be sure of that.
Robert Goulet will join the University of Southern California marching band at halftime as we look down from the airship Columbia with Joel Chamberlain at the controls. A Goodyear blimp.
And if they do take it to kick it deep, you can always take it in the end zone. But he's not going to kick it any kind that's going to be easy to field. You can bet on that.
McLaughlin.
See there?
Squibs it. It goes to the fullback, Ricky Bell, at the 30-yard line, and Bell comes back to the 40, maybe the 41. USC does something a little differently in receiving the kickoff. Remember, we pointed out they send 6 running backs as their 6 deep men. All the fullbacks are lined up for just that eventuality. And Ricky Bell brings it back. 11 yards to the 41 where the Trojans have it first down. 50 seconds to go in the first half, and Notre Dame has shocked the Trojans with a 24-0 lead.
Now Southern Cal has three times out left. They could go down the field and score.
Hayden sets him with Farmer at fullback. He gives the ball to Davis on a draw, and Davis gets to the 43. And Tom Eastman, number 42, read the play and got his man.
Now Southern Cal used one of those times out.
You don't hear as much about Tom Eastman, perhaps, as you do some of the other Notre Dame linebackers, but he's the man in the middle, 230-pound sophomore from Elkhart, and he's a good, solid football player. Quickly, let's go to Frank Gifford.
And earlier, we talked so much about the Heisman Award trophy. Tom Clements, a strong candidate early in the year, he had a chance to talk to Don Tollefson about that Heisman Award, one of the most coveted in all of football.
How much does all the talk about the Heisman Trophy affect you?
I don't think it affects me at all, because I really don't think about it until someone mentions it, really. I'm more concerned with, I want to do well, I want to play well, and I want the team to do well. And, you know, that's my basic interest, because if I do well and we lose like we did against Purdue, it's really, it's not very good, because there's no happiness in defeat, really. So I'm just concerned with playing and winning.
But do you feel any extra pressure, because every time the Heisman Trophy's mentioned, your name comes up?
No, I don't feel pressure. People associate my name with Heisman Trophy, that's fine if they want to, but, you know, I really don't think about it.
We come back to live action here in the Coliseum with 44 seconds to go. It's second down and 7 yards to go for Southern California as Hayden delivers the ball deep, and the pass is completed at the Notre Dame 37-yard line as Shelton Diggs, number 26, the flanker, who's been in motion in virtually every play and makes his first catch of the ball game for 20 yards. Here's a look at him.
And Notre Dame was in a prevent defense this time. They were in a 4-4-3. They're playing for the big ball. And the man made a good cut in there. And the ball was right where it should be, and they beat this linebacker. See, he was sort of sandwiched, and he was hit about the time he got it. He made a dandy catch.
And Mihalik is active, though, Woody. He dropped way back into that deep zone that time.
But that 4-3 is still a little bit vulnerable. A lot of teams have gone to a 3-5-3. Then Pat Hayden would probably run around them.
All right, he's had his conference on the sidelines with John McKay and the coaching staff as they spent the timeout. It's first down for Southern California at the Notre Dame 36-yard line. They have one timeout remaining. And Notre Dame with a big lead of 24-0.
Now let's see what Notre Dame gives them.
38 seconds to play in the first half.
Ah, they're up in their man-to-man. They may be shooting in there. Watch. They're going after him. Yep, there they go. There they go.
Going deep. Throwing the ball deep. It is incomplete. The pass intended for Shelton Diggs. John McKay was short at about the 15-yard line and wide open. Here's Diggs, the man for whom the pass was intended.
Notre Dame changed their pass defense entirely. They went after him on that one. The one before, they were in a 4-4.
Reggie Barnett, number 14, was right with him, and he was way deep. He just started dropping when the ball was snapped and just kept on dropping, figuring somebody was going to come that way, and sure enough, there he was. Hayden now is 4 out of 9 for 47 yards, has had one intercepted.
Looks like they're going to come again. Looks like they're going to come again. Look at him up there.
31 seconds to play in the first half. It's second down and 10 at the Notre Dame 36 for Southern California.
Automatic there. Automatic.
Good protection for Hayden. Goes to the sideline. Diggs has got it. Needs to get out of bounds. He cuts it back upfield, and he's got a first down at the Notre Dame 7-yard line with 22 seconds to play in the first half. They'll have to spend another timeout. 28 yards on the pass play. Steve Knutson, at number 77 on the right side of the Southern California offensive line, took a couple of Notre Damers out on that play as he stood like a tree and gave Hayden the time to throw the ball.
Could I take a guess on this one? The running pass? There, they did that to us and scored on it, and they might just come to running pass, and they can run two or three plays now if they're incomplete passes. And they almost have to go to the pass.
Notre Dame beefs up its defensive front as they go to the goal line group. Ball at the Irish 7-yard line, and Southern California in desperate need of some points on the scoreboard before time expires in the first half, and only 22 seconds remain. Notre Dame.
They can run three plays in that length of time at least.
Notre Dame jumping big to a 14-0 lead in the first quarter, added 10 points here in the second quarter to lead it 24-0. And Pat Hayden has come back from the sidelines now with no more timeouts remaining. Bell, number 42, is in at fullback. Obradovich is the tight end. Anthony Davis will be the tailback. John McKay will be the wide receiver. Shelton Diggs will be the flanker. McKay and Diggs both going wide to the left. Obradovich is a fine receiver, the tight end. He is to the right.
What's the running pass?
He's going in the wide side of the field. He's looking for John McKay. He's got it. He throws it too high. And Hayden is down hard as Stock leveled him. Hayden really took a shot from Jim Stock just as he delivered the ball. And you can see he's coming back to the huddle gingerly with 16 seconds to play in the first half. The emotion of the moment may keep him moving, but he'll feel that one tomorrow. We'll have the USC band for you at halftime, as we noted, with Bob Dulay, the featured performer.
They'll get off two more plays. They'll both be passes.
All right, John McKay is wide to the left side, Diggs to the right this time. Hayden comes back. He swings the ball out to Davis, running for the flag. Touchdown!
It's absolutely amazing what a team can do with a couple of times out. They march half the length of the field there and practically no time at all.
That was a lateral pass. He threw it absolutely down the line, and Anthony Davis, with his great speed, just simply outran the Notre Dame defenders into the corner. And finally, Southern California gets on the board as they go 59 yards in six plays, but used only 43 seconds to do it. Rob Adolph in the hole, and Chris Limahalu is in for the few extra point try, and it is blocked, picked up by Adolph, and he's dropped back on the 15-yard line. And so Notre Dame was coming all the way, trying to block that extra point try, and they got it. The man who got it, I do believe, was Kevin Nussbusch, number 60. Here's a look at the touchdown as Hayden comes back, sets quickly, and delivers the ball to Anthony Davis. Jimmy Stock, number 48, could not get outside to him as he stumbled there. And Davis just simply outran Greg Collins into the corner. And USC is on the board with 10 seconds to go in the first half. Limahalu, little guy, but he's got great range with that leg. He has a 50-yarder this year.
But he's not going to use range now. He's going to squib kick it. He's not going to give them a chance to return it with 10 seconds on the clock.
Ball is laying flat on the ground.
That's right.
McLean, 22. Urick, 40. The deep men for Notre Dame, a sophomore and a freshman. Now he goes to the kicking tee.
And he'll try to keep the ball on the ground. Of course, the clock doesn't start until the white team recovers it. So they'll still have time to run one play if they call a timeout. And they've got two times out left.
24-6 with 10 seconds to play in the first half. He rolls it downfield. Rolling around, and Notre Dame covers the ball back at the 22-yard line. Terry Urick, number 40, coming up to cover the ball for the Fighting Irish with 7 seconds to play in the first half. I would think Notre Dame would be very happy to go into the locker room at halftime leading 24-6. Wouldn't you, Coach Hayes?
Yes, accepting this drive by Southern Cal gives them sort of a lift, too. And I know they're way behind, but I think you'll see a whale of a ball game the second half. Because they did execute a magnificent drive there at the end of the half. That was great. And that last play was something I'll worry about till we play the ball game.
Tom Clements takes the snap, sits down with it, and time runs out.
That isn't a very pretty play there, but that's the way to do it.
And so after the first half of play here at the Los Angeles Coliseum, the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame, 24, Southern California, 6.
We'll be right back with more of Notre Dame versus USC on Phi Beta Football.
Seems I'm late for our little reception. No worries. I'm driving this new Subaru Outback. Shortcut. It's got full-time all-wheel drives, like my other Outback, so I can take it almost anywhere, like my other Outbacks. fact, there's only one difference, really. Matilda. It's got this stylish rear end to go with her.
Nice truck.
The all-new Outback Sport Utility Sedan from Subaru.
A good sweat isn't so good once the game is over. That's why there's Irish Spring Sport.
It has an extra antibacterial ingredient that kills odor-causing germs better than regular soap. It's Irish Spring Sport. Play as hard as you like.
If you remember correctly, I paid last time.
You didn't pay last time.
Great. I was wondering what that was.
Introducing the Coca-Cola ATM MasterCard. Redeemable at any MasterCard ATM for up to $100. If you haven't found one yet, keep looking.
You know all those stories you hear about how good it was and how much fun we had and how young we all used to be, about how much it all mattered and how much we all cared and how no one has ever done it higher or faster or harder or better. All those stories you hear, they're all true.
Traveler 2 is out. The music is conquest. It's always a thrilling thing for me to watch when that big white horse comes thundering around the track and the music strikes up for the full stadium. And I'll tell you this, the men of Troy have got themselves a problem. They trail 24-6 as we go to the second half with White 4-22. And Anthony Davis, number 28, the deep man, to receive the kickoff from Pat McLaughlin of Notre Dame, the Fighting Irish, wearing the white, and they dominated the first half of play. Here's the kick. McLaughlin knocks it high and deep. And Davis, 2 yards deep in the end zone, will bring it back. The wedge gets into the 20. He breaks it at the 25. He's long gone at the 40. It's now a foot race, and here goes Anthony Davis for 102 yards and a touchdown.
Impossible to believe. He's been stopped with about 2 yards on each play. The first half, he goes 102 yards on the first time he has an end on the ball. That's reminiscent of 2 years ago. So this makes it a great football game.
It's the second time this year that Anthony Davis has gone 100 yards plus with a kickoff. He did it in the opening game against Arkansas. That game the Trojans lost. But he has certainly aroused the stadium with that brilliant run, and give the guys the credit. The wedge blew the hole for him. Once he got it out, he was long gone. 102 yards for Anthony Davis.
And that man who did not throw downfield and didn't clip is a pretty smart fella, too.
Have another look at it.
Good wedge. Right up the middle of it. I'm amazed at that. Now he breaks it. Now he's all on his own. This fella can't. Got run 16, and he didn't throw. If he'd thrown there, it'd probably been a trick.
2 years ago, he ran him 97 and 96 yards for touchdowns against Notre Dame, and he continues to haunt Era Farsegian's Fighting Irish. Another look at it from a different angle. What's the wedge blow the hole for him?
Man barely got his hands on him. 1, 2, 3. He outran that man 4. And there he's gone. That's one of the great plays in football, certainly.
And they're
going for two.
Going for two. Southern Cal will go for two. At Hayden on a roll to the right side. Allen part of the tailback in front of him. Hayden is there. He didn't make it.
He didn't make it.
He was within a foot of getting there, and Drew Mihalik knocked him out of bounds. Number 45, saved the two-point try. Drew Mihalik, he has made three big, big defensive plays in the ball game for Notre Dame. Let's watch it again now and watch the flow of 45. Looked like Hayden was going to stick his head in there.
Sure did.
Now watch Mihalik.
There's one man down.
Here he comes, 45, beats off part of the tailback. And
boy, that was a great play for that defender. Great play.
And so, with 14:46 to go in the third quarter, Anthony Davis' touchdown run requiring only 14 seconds. for 102 yards. The score now is 24-12. Mark McClain, number 22, is deep for Southern California, along for Notre Dame, along with Terry Urich, the Southern California Swift Lima Halu now with a roar coming out of the Coliseum will kick it off.
It'd be ironic if they did the same thing.
McClain at the four.
They bring it across the field, they're not going to go.
Whoa! What a hit downfield by number 57, David Lewis. Notre Dame will have the ball.
The momentum up to this moment is switched. Unless Notre Dame can move the ball out of there, they're in trouble. If you just don't run east and west on a field, north and south, you don't go very far.
Watch the hit by Lewis now.
It's a great hit. Great hit. At least a man held on the ball.
All right. It's at the 8-yard line. It's the test of Notre Dame's boys right at this moment in the ball game as Clements turns around and gives the ball to Parisi, and Gary Jeter brings him down as he gets to the 11, maybe the 12.
You know, the defense looked a little tougher, a little meaner on that play than they have so far.
The halftime statistics, actually time of possession was not that different, but the total yardage certainly was, 256 to 161. All right, the ball is at the 12. It is second down and six for Notre Dame at their own 12. Clements gives to Samuel. He's up to the 15, to the 16-yard line. They're going to be looking at a third down and two. And here you see Notre Dame going into that misdirection offense.
Yes, sir, this is a key play. Third and two. Because if they don't, then they kick and Southern Cal will get the ball around midfield. My guess is they'll run their fullback. Either that or sweep. So here I am guessing.
All right, the heat's on the Notre Dame offense to keep possession of the ball on third down and two.
And the linebackers are cheating up in there. There they are.
They've got eight men up on that line. Southern California does. Clements going down the line, delivers the ball to Eric Finnick, trying to get outside. They've got it. Back at the 12-yard line, Art Riley, number 70, made the play. Ed Powell, 87, the outside linebacker to the open field side, was involved as well. So Riley and Powell.
That's a different defense in there for Southern Cal. There's just no question about it. They're going after him this half. Makes a lot of difference.
13 minutes to go in the third quarter. The complexion of things entirely different right now. On that 102-yard kickoff return by Anthony Davis. Now Notre Dame has got to kick the ball away. Cody Brantley standing in his end zone. He hits it up on the 3-yard line.
Doesn't get it very high.
It's returned by Charles Phillips to the Notre Dame 38-yard line, a 34-yard punt, a 7-yard return, and here you have Southern California steaming right now with a football at the Notre Dame 38-yard line. Score 24-12, the Irish lead.
We'll be right back with more of Notre Dame versus USC on Phi Beta Football.
I don't think this is working out.
You're dumping me?
I mean, you're a really nice guy and all.
Then what is it? Would it be that?
Don't let this happen to you. Drink Keystone Light, America's never bitter beer, so there's always a great taste, never a bitter face.
I've changed my mind.
As if.
Stop making faces. Drink Keystone.
I don't even know who that is.
Today, a breath of fresh air blew into the NBA when a 19-year-old kid made his debut and stole the show.
He was different. He played with such emotion. It's very simple. He had eyes in the back of his head.
Before he played, you could get seats.
That's why they call him what they do.
The great thing about life is you never know what you might want to do next. With the American Express card, it can be anything you like.
It's famous for hushing highways and reducing wind to a whisper. It's as comfortable and quiet as you want it to be. It's steering wheel-mounted audio controls that let you live your life like a movie and score your own soundtrack. It's a 210-horsepower performance, and you've got front-row seats. It's the RL from Acura. The true definition of luxury. Yours.
got an idea.
Wisdom doesn't come easily, nor is it easy to pass on.
Now Philips has a way to create your own CD that holds everything you know about the things that interest you. And share your words, pictures, and music with anyone you want.
Let's go!
Got anything for the pictures?
The Philips CD rewritable disk drive. Create CD-ROMs on your own PC.
You're watching Notre Dame versus USC on Phi Beta Football.
Here is a pressure point of the ball game. First down, Southern California at the Notre Dame 38. Five-man front defensively, 52 defense for Notre Dame. As Pat Hayden gives the ball to Anthony Davis. He's got 1 yard as he works down to the 37-yard line. Anthony Davis having set a new NCAA record for touchdowns on kickoff returns with 6. The old record was 5, held by Davis and Stan Brown of Purdue. Brown having played at Purdue in 1968, 69, and 70. And that's the way the Trojans line up along the offensive front. They're looking at 2nd down and 9 at the Notre Dame 37-yard line. It's a test of poise for both teams at this point in the game. 24-12, Notre Dame leading. Kelton Diggs goes in motion. Here's Hayden back to throw. He's got Diggs wide open on the right. Goes for McKay. McKay's got it. He whips the ball right into his hand and makes the catch off the Notre Dame 6-yard line. John Dubinetsi brought him down. The son of the SC coach, John McKay, makes a 31-yard reception.
He's got room to make his move.
That's his first catch in the ball game, and he really concentrates, Woody.
He's a great little receiver. We know that only too well.
That's right. Ball is at the Notre Dame 6-yard line now. The Irish defense digging in. SC trying to get themselves back into the ball game. Here's the pitch wide to Davis. The blocking on the right side. Touchdown!
Anyone who can figure out this football game is a genius.
Delton Diggs and Dave Farmer were the two men that made the blocks. Well, there's where that banner went to that we lost the last time we were out here. Well, whatever. We've got ourselves a roaring ball game as Chris Limahalu comes in to go for one this time. The hold is good, the kick is up, the kick is good. And so with 11 minutes and 35 seconds to play in the third quarter, we've got ourselves a ball game. Southern California goes 38 yards in 3 plays in 1:04. And the scoreboard now reads Notre Dame 24, Southern California 19. The Trojans having scored 2 touchdowns in 3:11.
And that's just about the way Notre Dame did the first half.
Right. So Anthony Davis resting, and let's have a look at the touchdown play. He's a tough little guy. All right, it's Urich 40, McLean 22, deep for the Fighting Irish. As Southern California's Lima Haley will kick it off. There's the story on the mark for the Trojan touchdown. This is a typical SC Notre Dame game. One of the great intersectional rivalries of all time. Here's the kick. It'll be McLean at the 1-yard line. Good hard run by McLean. Brings it back to the 22. Maybe the 23. That's where they'll put it. First down, 23, Ara Marsigian, the head football coach of Notre Dame, facing the sideline.
They've got to move the ball on this drive. They're in real trouble. They've got fair field position. They've got to move it now.
But Notre Dame averaged on first down plays in the first half 7.6 yards.
Isn't that amazing?
But so far, they have not been able to get on track as SC has exploded for 2 quick touchdowns here in the third quarter. And this crowd of 92,000 roaring, and Tom Clements will have none of it. He just walks away from the ball and will wait him out.
This is not fair. This is not fair. The quarterback isn't getting his chance.
All right, from the 23, Plymouth back, sets the throw, goes to the air. The pass deflected. Pass is incomplete. It was thrown upfield, intended for Pete Demily. Richard Wood coming in, putting on the pressure. Along the front, Notre Dame has Brenneman in the middle, Wujek and Donardo on each side of him. The tackles are Sylvester and Nice. The tight end is Weber. The wide man is Demily. And in the backfield, it is Plymouth, Maurice, Samuel in motion. Plymouth back to throw. Looks for Demily. Unloads it to the short man, Pinnick. Pinnick is run out of bounds. Shoved out of bounds by Marvin Cobb. Short of the first down. The advance of the ball up to the 26-yard line. That's put it down. Let's call it the 25-yard line. Well, it'll be third down and eight. Third and long. Notre Dame dominated the first half. Southern California being pulled along by the emotional surge that goes with a 102-yard touchdown by Anthony Davis on the opening kickoff of the second half. Plymouth gets the ball in the air. He's got a man wide open. The ball is fumbled. Southern California recovers Demily's fumble at the Notre Dame 35. Demily was leveled by Phillips. Here's the play. Pass on target. Now watch the hit.
Certainly open. There goes the ball. No question. What is the fumble?
Danny Reese, 46, hit him low. Phillips hit him high. Knocked the ball loose. Kevin Bruce covered it. Here we go. Southern California from the 36-yard line. Anthony Davis goes to the 33. Reggie Barnett of Notre Dame makes the tackle. There's Danny Reese. Number 46, who was involved in that big play just a moment ago. Farmer is out at fullback now for Southern Cal, and Dell comes in.
Emotion has to be the big thing. Now, it's changed the reverse now. Momentum, whatever you want to call it.
Second down and 7 yards to go for Southern California. As Hayden gives the ball on the reverse action to Shelton Diggs, the flanker. And he didn't get anything.
No, that Notre Dame line is still playing off a good ball inside.
Drew Mihalik, 45. Niehaus, number 70.
Now he just might come back with a pass off that same action, that counter action. He almost has to pass on this down.
I just don't believe, Woody, that you're going to run very much against this Notre Dame front.
Now it's a great defensive line.
Third down, 8 yards to go. Hayden, straight back, gets off the snap very quickly. Throws to the short man, and he dropped the ball. Did he hold on? No, he held on.
It's
worth another look, because Diggs was butter-fingering the ball as he went down.
He had it.
13.
First down.
Here's the play now, and watch this ball, thrown very well by Hayden, right into Diggs, hitting right in the numbers. He one-handed it on the way down.
Yes, Hayden's doing a beautiful job putting that ball in there. Notre Dame has not been rushing quite as hard this half either. They'll start coming to blitzes pretty soon now.
First down on the Notre Dame 21-yard line.
Here she comes.
Notre Dame with six men up on the defensive front. Hayden on a roll, trying to get away from the blitz. He got away from Fanning, gets the ball off. Johnny McKay at the 4-yard line. First down, Southern California.
That only means one thing, that those two men have been working together a lot.
Here's Hayden's roll now as we look at it again. Now watch McKay. Down on his knees, gets up. Makes a great catch.
Those two fellows have been playing together a long time, haven't they?
Yes, they have. All the way through high school. First down, goal to go, Southern California. Bidding for the lead right here on the Notre Dame 4-yard line. Hayden gives the ball to Anthony Davis. Touchdown! Anthony Davis has scored 3 touchdowns in less than 7 minutes in the third quarter. He has a total of 4 in the ball game.
That's the great thing about college football. It's totally unpredictable.
Another look at it. Watch the left side of the offensive line blow the hole for him. Again, remember, the SC tailback sets up 7 yards from the ball, gives him time to read the hole. So with 8 minutes and 37 seconds to play in the third quarter, the score now, University of Southern California 25, Notre Dame 24.
We'll be right back with more of Notre Dame versus USC on Phi Beta Football.
A good sweat isn't so good once the game is over. That's why there's Irish Spring Sport. It has an extra antibacterial ingredient that kills odor-causing germs better than regular soap. It's Irish Spring Sport. Play as hard as you like.
It's an Acura 24-valve V6, like the Acura NSX. It's the power of sequential multi-port fuel injection, like the NSX. It's four-wheel independent double wishbone suspension, like the NSX. It's comfortable seating for 5, like 2.5 NSXs. It's the TL from Acura, the true definition of luxury. Yours.
Classic Sports Network presents This Day in Classic Sports, May 21st, 1979. Streak Canadien after this.
This past Sunday, David Wells did what few pitchers have ever done.
Baseball immortality!
To celebrate one of baseball's rarest achievements, Classic Sports Network presents a tribute to the perfect game. Look back with Don Larson at his 1956 World Series gem.
27 up, 27 down!
And relive Jim Bunning's perfect day in 1964. Few pitchers have ever earned the right to be called perfect. Join Classic Sports as we salute them on tribute to the perfect game. Tonight at 8, only on Classic Sports Network.
May 21st, 1979. An ecstatic home crowd watches as the Montreal Canadiens ride a pair of second-period Jacques Lemaire goals past the Rangers 4-1 in Game 5 to take their 4th consecutive Stanley Cup. Tune in every day for This Day in Classic Sports.
Check out Classic Sports' website at www.classicsports.com for listings, legends, and the chance to tell us what you want to see on Classic Sports Network.
Classic Sports delivers the fight cards you don't want to miss. A ringside seat to the world's largest library of boxing's best fights. From lightweights to heavyweights, you don't have to wait, because every night is fight night. Tonight at the Fights, weeknights on Classic Sports.
We now return to Notre Dame versus USC on Phi Beta Football.
All right, here comes Southern California now for the extra point try, leading 25-24, and they're going to go for 2. Hayden pitches the ball to Anthony Davis on a sweep to the right side. He's in there. Oh, I'll tell you that Anthony Davis is a nightmare for Notre Dame. 2 years ago, he just tore them apart. Last year, they controlled him. But in this ball game today, he scored 26 points. And we've got 8:37 to go in the third quarter. Now, here's the pass play that set up the go-ahead touchdown for Southern Cal. As Hayden rolls to the right, John McKay, the son of the coach, down on his knees, got up. Hayden ran out of a tackle, jumped in the air, and delivered it like Harry Gilmer used to throw it at Alabama. And McKay, great catch on it. And here's the two-point extra point try that was successful as Anthony Davis went student body right and took it in. And Southern California has gone ahead of Notre Dame 27-24. And Obradovich and Bain made the big blocks to get Davis in for the 2 points. So the third quarter touchdowns for Southern Cal as they kick off have given the Trojans the lead. And now it is Mark McLean returning it for the Fighting Irish, and he gets out to about the 23-yard line, where the Irish will have it first down, and Anthony Davis can now sit down, have a drink of water, and take a nap if he wants.
I think one of the big things in the ballgame right now is the way this Southern Cal defense has come to life. They're not the same people they were the first half. They're taking the ball away twice now and giving given their own team scoring opportunities. They're playing a lot better ball.
They've given you a lot to think about on your ride home.
They certainly have. They certainly have. But we'll get these pictures.
All right, Notre Dame, with the crowd roaring, comes up. Tom Clements sets. Wayne Bullock is back in at fullback. He has the ball. Sprained his ankle in the first half. Back in for the first time in the second half and takes it from the 23 out to about the 25. Great fullback. Notre Dame needs him. Kevin Bruce and Gary Jeter make the stop.
He's limping pretty badly there.
All right, Pat Hayden, who's been just spectacular here in the second half.
Yes, he has.
His counterpart, Tom Clements, now on second down and 8 yards to go from the 25. Tom gives the ball away to Bullock again. And the fullback jams it over the right side out to the 28, and here's Jim Lampley.
You may never have seen a football game that turned around so quickly. You may also have never seen a Southern Cal team so consumed with emotion. At halftime, Coach John McKay told them they played badly in the first half, but he said the same thing had happened 10 years ago. He said they were going to bring the kickoff back in the second half, and then they were going to score and score and score again. That's exactly what they've done, Keith.
On third down and 3, Notre Dame trying to get it moving again. As Clement goes to throw, Ed follows after it, delivers the ball, and it is...
That rush played a big factor there. He had to throw off balance. Southern Cal's rushing better. And
I was almost picked off over there in the crowd.
Almost.
Have a look at Pete Nimmerly as he breaks it to the sideline. 85. Charlie Phillips, number 49, the man that gets after him right here. You see Richard Wood also dropping back, the linebacker. Had him well covered. Phillips almost got that ball. All right, Brantley will punt now for Notre Dame. Gets it off. It's a fine kick. Back at the 26-yard line. Southern California. And coming up the sideline, it is Marvin Cobb, number 24, with a football. He almost took it home.
No flags on the play either.
He brought it back 54 yards. Number 24, Cobb. Great All-American baseball player, incidentally. Watch him get out and walk the chalk on the sidelines as the picket line was set up very well for him. Art Riley, number 70, in the meantime, is down on the field, injured. You see Cobb almost break out of the stack. DiNardo, Jerry DiNardo, runs him down and trips him up with 7:02 to go. 27-24, USC leads it.
We'll be right back with more of Notre Dame versus USC on 5 Beta Football.
I don't think this is working out.
You're dumping me?
I mean, you're a really nice guy and all.
Then what is it?
Better be a razor!
Would it be that?
Don't let this happen to you. Drink Keystone Light, America's never bitter beer, so there's always a great taste, never a bitter face.
I've changed my mind.
As if.
Stop making faces. Drink Keystone.
I don't even know who that is.
You know, I was into all that extreme stuff when I was your age. Just didn't have a fancy name for it. Because I never had a Subaru Outback Sport either.
Too bad, Uncle. This beauty's got a ton of cargo space. Full-time all-wheel drive. More horsepower than a RAV4. We never did that, I'll bet.
Sure we did. But, what's the rape for?
Outback Sport, part of the Outback family from Subaru.
Announcing the arrival of the Coca-Cola ATM MasterCard. Redeemable at any consenting MasterCard ATM.
I'm just a love machine.
The world thinks American soccer is second rate. The world thinks we don't belong here. The world thinks our team is weak. The world thinks things that can intimidate me. We'll see about that.
Come on now, open up your front foot a little bit. Come on, man, you got hands up. Get within yourself.
I got an idea.
Wisdom doesn't come easily. Nor is it easy to pass on.
Now Philips has a way to create your own CD that holds everything you know about the things that interest you. And share your words, pictures, and music with anyone you want.
Let's go! Whoa!
Got anything for the pictures?
The Philips CD rewritable disk drive. Create CD-ROMs on your own PC.
We now return to Notre Dame versus USC on Phi Beta Football.
Southern California with a football, first down at the Notre Dame 19-yard line. Trojans blowing it open here in the third quarter. An incredible comeback. 27-24 lead. They give the ball to Anthony Davis. And he runs right at the right side from the 19 down to about the 15-yard line as Tom Eastman, the middle linebacker for the Fighting Irish, makes the stop. And there's Art Riley. He was injured in the kickoff play where Marvin Cobb almost broke it all the way on that 54-yard return. He'll try to shake it off. He is an outstanding football player. Ball is at the 15 now. Again, the Notre Dame defense trying to get a hold of somebody's shirt tail. Come up with a big play here to stop this Notre Dame march. Southern California just literally on fire here in the third quarter. Hayden back to pass. He's under pressure, and they've got it. Greg Collins, number 50, the linebacker, makes the stop.
So now they come up third and nine.
Greg Collins, a 230-pound senior out of Troy, Michigan. And we have seen him have some great days during his career at Notre Dame. The ball is on the 18-yard line. Anthony Davis in the ball game has picked up 56 yards rushing, 37 yards receiving, 147 yards return. So that's 240 total yards that he has produced today so far. With 5:45 to go in the third quarter. Third down and nine now as Hayden rolls to the left. Gets it off. Mahalik hits him just as he throws. Touchdown, McKay.
That had counteraction in there, and Heavenly has pulled off the corner, and he beats the halfback.
He got away from Barnett. In the third quarter, Southern California, in less than 10 minutes, has scored four times. Lima Halu for the point. It's good. Absolutely astounding football game. Let's watch John McKay now, number 25, sitting on the bench. Here's the replay as he goes down for the touchdown. 18-yard pass play. He runs a pattern as well as anybody. Takes his pump there, and he gets away from Payne.
He's dead.
Barnett couldn't get to him, and he's all alone. He's caught three passes, 67 yards, and one touchdown. Well, Ara Farsiga's got to feel like the sky is falling the way things have happened here in the third quarter. Yurikan McLean a deep for Notre Dame as Lima Halu kicks it out of bounds. That'll cost the Trojans five, and they'll redo it. 5:37 to go in the third quarter, and Southern California jumping out to a big lead. Here's Jim Lampley.
The man with me is Tony Preston, who's the director of sports for the BBC. This is the first time he's ever seen a football game. And Tony, keeping in mind you're watching an incredible one, how does this compare with soccer or some of the sports you televise?
Well, I don't know how it compares, but it's a most tremendous atmosphere, I must say. No, I mean, the thing that really struck me is atmosphere, the fact that you have offense and defense, and this boy Anthony Davis. I've never seen anything like it anywhere.
Very electrifying sport, isn't it?
It really is most exciting. Tremendous atmosphere.
Thank you very much. Back up to Keith Jackson.
Thank you, Jimmy. And here's Lima Halu kicking it again. Gets a little more to put into it. Mark McLean takes it at the 10-yard line for Notre Dame. Big return. Comes back to the 32 for 20 yards. And
Now again, it's a test of the poise of the Fighting Irish. To get something going here and take some of the heat off as David Lewis makes the tackle for Southern Cal. 34-24, SC leads. Dimmerly comes wide to the right. Parisi back in at fullback for the Fighting Irish. Samuel in motion. There's that draw play. McLean scored off of it a little while ago in the first half. Samuel gets the ball up across the 35. He's up to the 37. Give him 4 yards on the pickup. And the clock is running now at 5:15 to go in the third quarter. And USC leading by 10 points. The Trojans went to the locker room at halftime, down 24-6. Now it is 34-24. Notre Dame, second down and 6. Clements gives the ball to Parisi, and Tom is across the 40. Woody Hayes of Ohio State, our guest commentator today. And Coach Hayes, my guess would be if Notre Dame pull itself back together and pound it, carve it out, take it in.
Yeah, they're not out of the ball game yet. You can bet on it. If they get down the score, then she's still a heck of a ball game. This game is going to change hands yet.
4 minutes.
No one there. Here's your tight defense now. They're going to stop them in there.
Eight-man front.
Yep, they stopped him. They stopped him.
Parisi on third down and a yard and a half is hit by Kevin Bruce, who is the leading tackler for Southern California, and they've got him short of the first down.
Yeah, they stepped up both linebackers in there and stopped it. And now Notre Dame has to punt.
On fourth down.
They might go for it. They might even have a fake punt and pass. If they have it, now would be the time to use it.
Notre Dame has scarcely seen the ball here in the second half, and they're going to go for it.
They're going to go for it. I don't blame them. Got to come this way.
Parisi, the fullback. He may have it, or he may not. I don't know.
That's real close. From where the man standing over there, it says no. It's going to be awfully close.
Well, he took the ball in behind number 71, Steve Sylvester, who may be the best of the blockers along the Notre Dame front. He's been an outstanding blocking tackle all season long for Ara Parsegian, and it's close enough for the chain gang to come on the field, and this may be one of the big, 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 big moments in this ball game.
If he made it, he didn't make it by more than 6 inches.
All right, here's the stretch out of the chains. He's got his first down. First down, Notre Dame.
That's a real big play in this ball game.
Of course, the man sitting to my right, Woody Hayes, would like to play the Southern California team and talk about the national championship. Of course, Ara Parsegian in Notre Dame takes on undefeated Alabama in the Orange Bowl. And the other undefeated team, Oklahoma, of course, will not be playing in a postseason game. As you see, the scoring drives for USC. But right now, Notre Dame has the ball. First down at their own 43-yard line. And Tom Clements back to throw. He's under heat. He's going to have to run it. He's belted as he gets across the 45 to the 47-yard line, and he's hit by Danny Reese. Pete Dimmerly is the man, of course, they're doubling up on now. You see Powell, the linebacker, outside linebacker, bump him at the line of scrimmage, bumped him again, and now Dimmerly trying to break into the secondary, and he's picked up by Richard Wood, and now here come the defensive backs, and they hit him. And so Dimmerly's having a rough time up there. I'm not sure, but what a flag could have been thrown on that one. But it wasn't. It's second down and 6 from the 47 for Notre Dame. Here's McLean getting around the corner across the 50 down to the Southern California 46, and that should be a first down for Notre Dame.
That youngster obviously has fine speed. He cleared that corner in great style.
Ball is marked at the Southern California 46-yard.
Well, he's trying to figure what went for him early in the ball game, and if you remember early in the game, he was passing on that first down.
Right.
That's when he went in so quickly, and he just make him up again on that first down pass.
Well, he averaged 7.6 on a per yard,
yes,
per first down, but here in the second half, it's been 2.7. They go to Parisi, the fullback. He's got a couple of yards, and that's all, as the Trojan linebackers hammer him.
Creasy's a good one, but he isn't as good as Bullock. Notre Dame is hurt by the loss to Bullock. There's no question about it.
For one, he's not as big, and two, I don't think he's quite as strong.
Well, he hasn't had the experience either.
Speaking of total yardage, there's a comparison to give you an idea of what kind of a third quarter Anthony Davis has had.
Incredible. He's had a lot of experience.
Just inside the 45, second down, 8 yards to go. Notre Dame keeps it in the middle with Parisi carrying the ball. And he's down to the, maybe inside the 40.
Got about a third and three, I believe.
Looks like Otha Bradley, the middle guard, is down on the field for Southern California. Well, there's a former Trojan sitting there. He's not a former Trojan. Once a Trojan, always a Trojan, right, Frank? But you've got to be suffering sitting up there in New York watching this on pins and needles as your Trojans come battling back.
Well, Keith, I was suffering at halftime. Things have turned around a little bit. I know Coach Woody Hayes has probably seen a team come in like Notre Dame did, take a big lead, and all of a sudden they feel they have total control of the game. They had a 24-6 lead. They come out and kick off to Anthony Davis, and all respect to Archie Griffin. Woody Hayes, Anthony Davis is a pretty good football player. He runs it back 102 yards. All of a sudden it turns around, and the problem now is to reverse that. You as a head coach, I know Woody Hayes, and of course Eric Parsegian is feeling that right now. How do we turn it around? It's not easy once you lose the momentum, and SC, with that great defensive talent, well, yeah, I think it's going to be one of the most exciting games of the year. In my estimation, it already has been.
All right, Frank. The ball is at the 39-yard line for Notre Dame, the 39 of Southern California. The Fighting Irish have to go to the 36 to get their first down. They are looking at a third down and three. They gambled on a fourth down play to keep the ball. Here's the ball given to number 24, Samuel, coming around. He is at the 35, and he's got a first down for Notre Dame. First down for the Fighting Irish at the Southern California 35, and 2 minutes and 18 seconds to play in the third quarter. USC leading it, 34-24. The halftime score was 24-6 for Notre Dame. It's Pinnick in motion. Clements back to throw. Tom delivers, intended for Samuel. And it's deflected.
Great defensive play.
Ron Bush, number 23, made the defensive play, a sophomore out of San Bernardino for the Trojans. Tom Clements trying to lob the ball over the defensive man's head. Otha Bradley suffered an arm injury, the middle guard. Down in the elbow area, so he is out of the ball game at the moment for Southern California. Larry Nunnally and Pat Morris are the men to back him up. The man that goes in there right now is Tim Reams, number 97, a junior out of Fresno. And it is second down and 10 for Notre Dame. At the SC 35, Finnick in motion. Clements back to throw again. He has time. He throws. It is intercepted by Charles Phillips. Knocked out of bounds by Sylvester. Phillips with his second interception of the day. Returns it 37 yards.
That could be the turning point of the ball game right there, because Notre Dame had a pretty good drive going at this point.
You're watching Notre Dame versus USC on 5 Beta Football.
The Millennium!
It just tastes better.
Come on now, open up your front foot a little bit. Come on, man, you got hands up. Get within yourself.
I got an idea.
Wisdom doesn't come easily, nor is it easy to pass on.
Now Philips has a way to create your own CD that holds everything you know about the things that interest you, and share your words, pictures, and music with anyone you want.
Pictures?
The Philips CD rewritable disk drive. Create CD-ROMs on your own PC.
I know this machine inside out. They are great machine. They hardly ever break. There is only this one in town, but I've always taken care of it. and it only takes about 3 days to get spare parts.
Oh, vaya.
Another.
Got a backup plan? Take American Express traveler's checks. $300 worth could save the day.
It's famous for hushing highways and reducing wind to a whisper. It's as comfortable and quiet as you want it to be. It's steering wheel mounted audio controls that let you live your life like a movie and score your own soundtrack. It's a 210 horsepower performance, and you've got front row seats. It's the RL from Acura, the true definition of luxury. Yours.
We decided to get a PC.
We?
But we didn't want to pay for a lot of fancy extras. Gateway even told us what not to get.
When you call 1-800-GATEWAY, we build a Gateway computer just for you.
We built the Geissler's a PC for cruising the net with a powerful Intel Pentium 2 processor and a printer for only $14.99.
Let's email the kids our scores.
Want us to build a PC to fit your budget? Call us. Let's talk about your Gateway.
What's your favorite sports memory? Is it Reggie's three homers in Game 6? Or Michael's six three-pointers in Game 1? Or maybe it was the time you and your dad had the best seats in the house. Send your favorite sports memory to Classic Sports Network, Murray Hill Station, P.O. Box 1830, New York, New York, 10156. Because we want to hear what you want to see.
We now return to Notre Dame versus USC on Phi Beta Football.
All right, here comes Southern California now with Dix going in motion. Shelton Dix to the right, Anthony Davis going the same way. Davis the tailback. Takes it from the 15 down to the 46-yard line before Kevin Nussbusch makes the tackle. The score at halftime was 24-6. Notre Dame leading. The Fighting Irish had absolutely dominated the game. But as Coach Woody Hayes pointed out, SC took it in for a big score at the close of the first half. A 102-yard touchdown run by Anthony Davis with the opening kickoff of the second half. And Notre Dame under pressure all the way as Southern California just absolutely exploded to score 28 points in the third quarter with a minute and 17 seconds remaining. Here is Hayden giving the ball to the fullback Ricky Bell. And Bell takes it to the 40 inside the 40, and that will be a first down.
Incidentally, on the previous play, Ricky Bell got a great block. Then they come back and fake the sweep and hand the ball under his elbow to Ricky. It's only poetic justice that he should get the chance to carry the ball, and he certainly did.
Well, I'll back up, Woody. That is not quite a first down. They mark him just short of the 40. Third and just inches.
Here's where I like to go into the robust.
Mosu Tatupu is now in at fullback, a freshman out of Honolulu, as Hayden goes for the first down and should have it. It is a first down. Bob McCaffrey, the center, led him. As we look down on the Los Angeles Coliseum with some 92,000 people, we look down from the airship Columbia with Joel Chamberlain at the controls, the Goodyear blimp. The lights are on in the Coliseum. Notre Dame sends a six-man front up. Dubinetsky, a cornerback, comes up. Here's Hayden dropping back to throw all the time. Now he runs out of time. He gets around the corner, and he's run out of bounds.
That's the amazing thing that Hayden does right there. When he gets in trouble, he can run enough to get back near that line of scrimmage, and that's what he did. He's not a great runner, but he certainly is a timely one.
He lost about 2 yards on that play.
He could have lost a lot more, though.
Second down and 12 now for Southern California. Hayden in the second half, 4-for-4, 80 yards and a touchdown. Plus a couple of other passes that set up scoring opportunities. Hayden swings it out to Davis. Gives stock right there. Loss on that play back to the 45-yard line. Woody, how long can you keep up that kind of momentum.
You know, I was just asking myself that question. They're probably a little tired. They've had the ball a lot this quarter, and they've run a lot. They may be a little bit tired at this point.
You know that so many games are played in surges. One
That's
surges,
right.
the other
That's
surges.
That's right.
And you got to sooner or later step back and take a deep breath. It's third down and 15 for Southern California. Hayden going deep. McKay wide open. Touchdown.
Someone fouled up on that pass coverage there. Just happy. Of course, they're swinging the tailback out this way to make it a flood area. Somebody missed the man down the middle, and the post is wide open. And McKay is certainly having a good day. Let's just hope that he's having his best day today.
Here he goes. They just left him alone.
Yeah, someone fouled up on that one. You see, they sent the tailback to swing out of the backfield. And someone overplayed it.
Randy Harrison, number 10, was the closest man to him. The freshman out of Hammond, Indiana. McKay ran right by him, and Hayden was perfect on the pass.
Certainly was.
McKay now with four catches, 112 yards, and two touchdowns. Terry O'Neill, our statistician, digging into the history books. He's been digging a whole third quarter.
You know, this is the thing we've always said about John McKay's team. They can run and pass better than any team in football. And it's certainly been proven here in this quarter.
35 points against a Notre Dame football team anytime, any year is
That's
an
right.
incredible fact.
Against the number one defensive team in the country, although you've got to admit, it's been in the past defense that they've hurt them the worst. Now they've got them sort of like an accordion going in and out.
All right, here's Limahalu for the extra point try. Bob Adolph holds it. It's good.
I hate to mention it, but 2 years ago they did this same thing to us in the third quarter.
41-24 after three.
We'll be right back with more of Notre Dame versus USC on 5 Beta Football.
A good sweat isn't so good once the game is over. That's why there's Irish Spring Sport.
It has an extra antibacterial ingredient that kills odor-causing germs better than regular soap. It's Irish Spring Sport. Play as hard as you like.
Does a car have instincts? Can it anticipate the next curve? One car can make you believe it does. With a patented steering and suspension system, you have the agility to outsmart the most elusive of roads. Now you can get low 1.9% finance on Intrigue and all Oldsmobiles. Intrigue, a sophisticated twist on a sports sedan.
The Millennium!
It just tastes better.
Two different worlds. A paper world, a digital world. Worlds that didn't always work together. Until now.
The Xerox Document Center. The digital copier printer with so many possibilities, we put it in a video.
The Document Center talks to any computer on your network. Stay at your desk and have it print, copy, collate, staple, even fax without getting up. Let the Document Center know what to do, and it shows you everything is fine. You can scan a page and see it on your screen. Now make a change, email it to George, then on to Sally, who prints it out. Your free video also shows how the Xerox Document Center has built-in internet access, so it responds to a print or fax command from anywhere in the world.
And since it's modular and upgradable, you only buy what you need. Call for your free video now.
What's digital? What's paper? What's the difference?
I wanted a drafting career where I could draw more than just a good salary.
Computers are the future of drafting, and I'm part of it. I trained in computer-aided drafting at ITT Technical Institute. ITT Tech could mean a successful future for you, too.
For an informative brochure, call ITT Tech at 1-800-791-2908. That's 1-800-791-2908.
Welcome to the future of drafting.
Wow, I bet the guys that run this stuff spent years in school.
No, you might be surprised.
So what are the chances of me getting to work here?
Well, first of all, you gotta love to draw.
And second?
And second, you gotta call ITT Tech.
For an informative brochure, call ITT Tech at 1-800-791-2908. That's 1-800-791-2908.
We now return to Notre Dame versus USC on Phi Beta Football.
Here we go to the final 15 minutes of football in the 46th renewal of this intersectional rivalry between Notre Dame and Southern California. Zurich 40 and McLean 22. Lima Halu kicks off for Southern California. It goes to McLean at the 12-yard line. He's back to the 24-yard line, and he is hammered. If you're thinking about records, the most points ever scored in one quarter, 49 by Davidson against Furman back in 1969. So here's a look on that last touchdown as John McKay goes in almost untouched. Certainly all alone when he made the catch on the perfect pass from Pat Hayden to give Southern California a 17-point lead, 41-24. All right, here's Notre Dame with Tom Clements now. Gets the ball to Pennick. Fumble. Can't find the handle. SC jumps on it. The Trojans have it at the Notre Dame 15-yard line. And the sky has indeed fallen on Notre Dame.
That happened 2 years ago, right about the same position on the field. The same man.
Kevin Bruce, number 50, comes out of the stack with the ball. Notre Dame has turned it over four times.
In the first half, Notre Dame played errorless ball. They had one interception.
Ball is marked at the 16 of Notre Dame for its first down, Southern California, as McKay and Diggs go wide left. Bell, the fullback, Davis, the tailback, Hayden, the quarterback, Obradovich is the tight end. And Hayden rolls left to the wide side, going to put it out, goes into the end zone! Touchdown! It's McKay, or is it Diggs? It's Diggs. Number 26, Shelton Diggs, makes the catch. And it's one of the most incredible turnarounds I have ever seen in a football game.
I don't think you need to qualify it, Steve. I think it is the most that I've ever seen. They just make it look easy.
To go in the ball game, and Southern California has now put 47 points on the scoreboard. It was 24-6 at halftime, Notre Dame leading. Watch the touchdown as Dick goes down into the corner. Got away from Barnett. Hayden's pass on the money.
And a fine catch.
Lima Halu for the point. It's good. So the Southern California passing attack, as you look at Ara Parsikian, and Ara, beleaguered at the moment.
Who wouldn't be?
Oh, I should say. There's Pat Hayden, who was frustrated. And Shelton Diggs, frustrated in the first half. But it's all joy on the Southern California side of the Coliseum at the moment.
And you know, yet you've got to realize that the defense for Southern Cal has done a great job this half. They've given their team the ball in excellent field position all the time.
48-24. Southern California has doubled Notre Dame, and they were down 24-6 at halftime. That is a new record, the most points ever scored against Notre Dame in one quarter. We suspected that. 35 points by Southern California in the third quarter. Limahalu knocks it down to the 2-yard line. And McLean gets it back to the 20-yard line. Purdue, back in 1960, scored 31 points in a quarter against the Fighting Irish. Southern California has taken that record out of the book with 35 here in 1974. All right, Tom Clements comes on with 14 minutes and 39 seconds to play in the ball game, and the score 48-24 against him. McLean goes in motion. He has the ball.
Good speed.
He gets about 4 yards out to the 24-yard line before Ed Powell, number 87, carries him out along with Kevin Bruce.
You know, the most unpredictable thing in the world is human emotions.
Yes, it is.
Yes, sir. The tide has turned.
Second down and 6 for Notre Dame from the 24. Clements to throw. Swings it short.
The first down.
And McLean gets the first down as he works his way out to about the 35-yard line.
Southern Cal now playing a very, very deep safety for obvious reasons. That's why the pass was so open in the flat.
George Stewart, number 90, checks into the defense, replacing Art Riley for Southern California at a defensive tackle position. Ed Powell, the outside linebacker, comes up on the line of scrimmage. Clements back to throw. Gets away from one. Gets his pass off. The pass is caught at midfield. And to the SC 49-yard line, it's Ken McAfee, number 81, who was a very prominent figure in the first half for Notre Dame. Number 81.
That's very similar to the pass that McCabe caught down near the goal line. The man had to come back. Coming back inside now.
And the quarterback Clements that time out, able to get away from the pressure and give the man time to work free. Of course, that man should never stop working in that secondary. Only that quarterback's got some room. They go to McLean. He's decked for a 2-yard loss.
And still, that was a tackle. Who was that?
Gary Jeter, number 79. Jeter. You remember him. He's out of Cleveland.
Sure do. We recruited him real hard.
He's only a sophomore. You may get to see him some more and more, would he?
That's right. I hope we do.
Ball is at the 49. Second down and 12 for Notre Dame. Clements to put it up. Intercepted. Intended for McAfee. It may be 6. Here goes Phillips.
Way. It's all the way.
Touchdown. 58 yards. Charles Phillips with his third interception of the day, and he finally got himself some points. The most points ever scored against a Notre Dame football team. On the road, 59 points. Edward Army. And that may be wiped out today because Southern California's got 54 and they're going to 55 right now. They've got it. Oh, incredible. Just absolutely an astounding football game.
That game is now known as the comeback. Perhaps not quite as great as Richard Nixon's, but still quite a comeback. Ara Parsegian would later say, it was one of the most unusual games I was ever involved in. On the sidelines with USC coach John McKay was his offensive coach, Craig Fertig, a Trojan alumnus who quarterbacked a come-from-behind 20-17 victory 10 years earlier. As he took the team into the locker room, trailing at the half, McKay told his players about Fertig's 1964 comeback. Apparently, the Trojans found the tale inspiring. It was the damnedest thing I ever saw in football, Coach McKay said of his dramatic USC victory. He then took the Trojans into the Rose Bowl, where they beat Ohio State and won the national championship. Notre Dame went on to beat Alabama in the Orange Bowl when Parsegian earned his 95th and final victory as coach of the Irish. Classic Sports Network returns in a moment.
Acura presents Big Man on Campus. He is the greatest quarterback that ever played pro football, but he never was named All-America in college. Despite developing a penchant for dazzling play and late-game heroics, none more incredible than the 22-point comeback against undefeated Houston in the Cotton Bowl in a game where he fought the elements and hypothermia.
It's a touchdown! Unbelievable finish.
Montana never was officially recognized as the elite quarterback in college. Big Man on Campus was brought to you by Acura, the true definition of luxury, yours.
It's a 170-horsepower race-bred engine. It's double wishbone suspension that slices, dices, and julienne's corners. It's quite possibly all the fun you need. It's the Integra from Acura, the true definition of luxury, yours.
The wonderful world of sports, we bring you Home Run Derby, where each week the leading home run hitters of the major leagues will compete in a home run hitting contest. You'll meet such stars as Duke Snyder, Eddie Matthews, Rocky Colavito, Ernie Banks, Mickey Mantle, Henry Aaron, Harmon Killebrew, Willie Mays, and many others.
Hi there, everybody. I'm Mark Scott, and today on Home Run Derby, we have Wally Post, who defeated our six-time champion Hank Aaron, going against one of the great young hitters of the National League, Dick Stewart. The boys have just finished their batting practice, so let's meet them, shall we? Come on in. Wally, good to see you again.
Thanks, Mark.
Dick, welcome to Home Run Derby.
Thank you, Mark.
Fellas, as you know, the winner today will receive $2,000. The loser, $1,000. As a bonus, any time you hit three home runs in a row, it's worth $500. The fourth home run in a row, another $500. And each consecutive home run after that, $1,000. You'll play nine innings, you'll get three outs per inning. Any ball not hit out of the ballpark for a home run is an out. Now, the pitchers are out there to throw the ball over the plate so you can hit it. But a swing and a miss and a called strike also constitutes an out. Now, Dick, as the winner of our last contest, Wally will be the home team. That means you'll bat first, so good luck to both of you.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank you, Mark.
Good luck, Dick.
Good luck, Wally.
We'll start Home Run Derby in just a moment.
This Classic Sports Network presentation is brought to you by Frost Brewed Coors Light, who reminds you the three most important words are, hey, beer, man.
I won't rest until every thirsty beer-drinking adult has a cold Coors Light in his hands. Rest. Rest is for the peanut vendors and the nacho guys. The folks who frost brew Coors Light, they don't rest until it's perfectly refreshing. And it's my job to get it to you that way. Oh, there's no rest for the beer man, not until every fan here is refreshed.
Joey, you ready?
I think everyone here is pretty refreshed, right?
It's an Acura 24-valve V6, like the Acura NSX. It's the power of sequential multi-port fuel injection, like the NSX. It's four-wheel independent double wishbone.